What's up, guys? Brooke here.
Hey, what's up, guys? It's Brooke's Little Life. Welcome back to my channel. And today is our last South Dakota vlog because in just a couple days we are moving to another state. So excited for that. But we're doing something a little exciting on our last weekend here in South Dakota. We're actually driving to Pierre, South Dakota.
State capital, South Dakota.
And there's a air show called Let Freedom Fly tomorrow, Saturday. So we're gonna go to that. Today's Friday, and we're gonna go stay at a hotel, see the Missouri River. So yeah, this will be the most Midwest I've ever been. Carson is so excited because there's some airplanes he's never seen before.
F-16, which is the main one for the F-16 demo at the very end. And the B1 Bomber flybys. I've never seen that one fly in person before. F-16 closes the show. So you're gonna hear like one of the loudest planes ever. Some say it's the loudest ever to begin with. If it's a flyby.
I'm scared, but I'm excited. There's no one I'd rather go to an air show with than this guy right here.
Yay!
And we stopped to get snackies before. So I just want to show Carson my little surprise that I got for him.
What?
We'll see how he reacts.
What could it be?
This is what I got him, you guys.
Is that an energy drink?
Here you go. This is a Black Rifle Coffee Company Espresso Mocha. 200 of caffeine.
You got sugar?
He loves caffeine. Oh, I didn't even look. It has 22 grams of sugar.
Okay.
Oopsie! Keep you awake for the 3 hours. I might take a nap here.
I'll take you closer then, because I don't want to.
I gotta make sure you're awake, though. Got him that fun little drink to try.
Thank you.
And I got us some water because we don't know if we can bring our water bottles to the air show. So we just got some clear waters in case. And some barbecue chips. Dang, we got like barely any service. It's just a bunch of cows and green grass. Okay, I'm trying to look up like a couple's Q&A type of thing. So you guys can get to know us as a couple better, because I know my channel's still new and we haven't really like gotten to know each other a lot. So how about we just take turns asking each other 3 questions each. So I'm gonna go first. I'm gonna ask you to tell the people what went through your mind when you first met me in person. Because you guys, we met on a dating app, Bumble, and we were like talking on the phone, FaceTiming and stuff, so I could make sure he's not a catfish or vice versa. And then we met in person, and I just like remember when you first saw me. So like, I just want you to tell them, these people right here, what thought went through your mind?
In person?
And leading up to it, like were you nervous to first see me in person? Did you think I was gonna look different than on the phone? Or like, did you have any fears? Did you, were you excited? Like, what was going through your head before that moment you saw me in person?
Well, I was definitely nervous.
Well, we know that one.
I was excited too.
You're so cute.
But oh, I was nervous because I was like, what if I'm not what she expects? What if I'm, I don't know. What if I'm crazy in person or something?
Crazy.
And she's like, all right, I think I'm gonna go now. It's only been like 3.5 minutes.
Dang. Luckily, that didn't happen.
She had a big smile, even bigger than that right there.
Yeah, I was like, I was so smiling, you guys, because for me, I got shy because he's so tall. And I was like, oh my God, like the tallest boy I've ever like dated. And I was like, whoa, because I'm 5'8", so I'm pretty tall, so it's not usual for me to like find guys that are like tall. So he was like, how tall are you? I don't even know how tall you are. We've been dating for 4 years. 4 years now, you guys. He's 6'2", whatever. I'm not bragging or anything. But I was like, well, he's tall. So like, you know, got little butterflies there. And like his blue eyes like piercing my soul. And I was like, okay. Because I've also never dated a boy with his eyes. So that was exciting for me. So it was like all basic like appearance at first. It was like, oh God, this is what he looks like, you know? And yeah. Then it was like, give me a hug. Okay, now I can smell him. Oh, he smelled good. He put on some cologne or something. Something smelled good. Cause you know, like you hug and you're just like, what do they smell like, you know? So that was cool. And my dog liked it. So my husky, Zoe, was there with me when I met him. You know, if your dog likes somebody, they don't start barking or growling, then you kind of approved of him too. So that was good. It's a really cute babe. Aww.
So if you're wondering why I was so nervous, probably because she was the first girl I've ever dated.
Yeah, like I'm the first girl you talk to on like a deeper level. I'm like his first girlfriend. And that's a lot of pressure, you guys. Like, help me out. I don't know what I'm doing still. So now it's your turn to think of a question so they can know us a little bit better as a couple. And also, guys, there's a bunch of cows out there on the field and I'm freaking obsessed because I love cows. Oh!
What was your favorite thing about me when we first met? Oh. Or what made me different?
When we first started talking or when I first met you in person?
Either. Or both.
Okay, my answers are so easy because he is so different than other guys I've dated because he remembers the little things, you guys. Like, he remembers the little details. The other thing is his voice, you guys. I was like, whoa, he has this deep voice. And I was like, okay. Like, you had like this
deep, dark voice, like, hey.
And I was like, okay. But he has a deep voice, but he's like so sweet and soft and nice on the inside. But he's like this, like, hey, on the outside. And it's just like my favorite thing about you. And I love you.
I've never been complimented on my voice before.
My older sister
said,
you know, she noticed it too right away. She was like, whoa, is your voice fake? She was like, that's not real. He can't even go high pitched. Like, sing a falsetto note right now. Like, like, do that. By the way, I'm not a singer.
I don't know how to begin with that.
Just try it. Yeah, so that's not going anywhere for him. But, so those are my two things about Carson that I love the most, or set him apart a little bit, I think. What were the top things about me that you were like, yes, I like this girl, or this girl could be my first girlfriend?
Let's see, I would say your happiness, friendliness, lovingness, all combined. Made you fun to be around. Plus she has that laugh, she's always laughing and smiling. I was like, I want to be around that a lot. Someone that's okay. Happy and smiling.
Aww. That's sweet.
The other thing, I guess, would be...
Better think of something.
Well, I like your board game playing.
Aww.
I played board games growing up when I was little. And then when I met Brooke, she played them all the time. So then I got back into playing board games with her. And every time I would see her, I seen that I would end up playing a board game. Sometime.
That is so true. That is something about me.
And that was fun. It's like, ooh, what game are we gonna play now?
Yeah.
Next time I go over, what's the game gonna be?
Well, I don't know. I've always loved board games, and growing up, like, I would always make my little sister play them with me, and we would just hang out and play them and listen to, like, music. It was just so fun. I actually collect Monopoly games, you guys. I'm a nerd.
There's a birdie up there. Bird's nest.
Guys, look at the Missouri River. A nice guy gave us a coupon. Just walking along this path with this dog. That was so nice, huh? This hotel is so adorable, you guys. And we have a view of the Missouri River, which is how many miles long?
2,341.
So. What? That's a long river. Now where are we going?
We're gonna drive in. Pierre, back
across
hometown.
Across
the bridge and try to drive by the state capitol building to check that out.
Okay,
fun. And just drive around.
Drive around good old Pierre, South Dakota. We're gonna cross over the Missouri River.
And there it is, Drifter's Bar and Grill. That's the restaurant.
Ooh, we're going over. Who is this guy? Hello, Sigurd Anderson.
Placed beneath this stone on July 4th, 1977, is a time capsule to be opened on July 4th, 2075.
Whoa, what's in it?
Don't know. The mystery.
What the?
Was it left in 2075 and find out?
Whoa.
So we just saw the state capitol building of South Dakota. What did you think of that, babe?
I thought that was very cool. I think it was my first time seeing a state capitol building in person, I think.
He thinks. I have seen Washington, D.C., baby, capital of the country.
There we go.
Oh, man. Now where are we going?
I'm trying to find one other area.
I liked all the flowers and green grass and trees around this capitol building. It's so beautiful, you guys. Guys, I told Carson, what does this cloud look like to him up here? And I'm saying it looks like a crocodile. Do you see that?
Yeah, it's an alligator.
It's an alligator? No, it's a crocodile.
Pointing us to reptile garden.
It's a crocodile, not an alligator. Come on, man, look at that snout. Okay, we've decided we're gonna go eat at, what is this place called?
It's called Drifter's Bar and Grill.
And I'm so excited because I'm hungry.
They're in an outdoor area, but that's just all, it's all full, so I don't think we're gonna get outdoors.
Pretty crowded here, so.
It's surprising, yeah.
I say that like I come here all the time. I've never been here, but yeah, and we're just watching these guys fish on their boat on
Hopefully
the Missouri
their food's
River.
Good.
Hopefully their food's good, yeah. Hope. Here's hoping.
You know what's weird?
What?
This restaurant closes in 30 minutes at 9 o'clock.
9?
It's still this party outside.
Wait, 9 p.m.? Show me the time.
9 p.m. 8:32.
And it's this bright, you guys. This is not 9 p.m. too. Ain't no way.
Sunset is at 9:12.
P.m.
P.m., yes, that's sunset. Oh my god. Who are eating dinner?
No way. No way sunset's at 9:12 p.m. Ain't no way. Do you know who's singing right now?
Lana.
How'd you know?
Right.
How'd you know?
Because I've heard you play this song 100 times, Mike.
No, I haven't.
Summertime.
Summertime what?
Sadness. Not here in South Dakota. Summertime happiness here.
So I bumped my knee.
There's Brooke faking an injury.
I bumped my knee on the table and it hurt.
Bumped her knee and Shane was going to survive the incident.
No.
There she is. Now she's sleeping.
Oh.
Now she's awake. There she is, broken wheels.
Oh boy, do I love the smell of manure on a Friday night.
Good morning, guys.
It is air show day.
It's air show day. Just woke up like 30 minutes ago. I did. He woke up like an hour ago and I slept so well in the hotel room. But now we're going to the air show and I'm so excited to see airplanes. What?
You are?
Yeah. We brought our little camping chairs and got my sunglasses because it's cloudy today.
Hopefully it isn't too sunny, but I don't want to be cold either. I don't want to be cold, but I don't want to be too hot.
No.
Well, I'm ready when you are.
Okay then. You're in the driver's seat.
It's 13 minutes.
Take us there. We're at the airport now, guys, and we're driving on the grass field to go to the parking.
Just some random grass field by the airport.
Are we going to Disneyland or what?
I think so.
They're telling us exactly where to park, and there's so many people here. Hi.
Hello.
You excited?
Oh, I'm excited.
All right, me too. Let's go do this air show, you guys.
I see some dark clouds, so hopefully it won't rain.
We got our chairs, our waters.
This is a good temperature.
Yeah, this is a nice weather. Look at the sky. Walked a mile to get to the entrance. So excited.
A half mile.
Whatever.
We're in.
We're in. We got our wristbands.
You can wait in that line if you want to and go inside of it.
Devil dog.
See the guns up sticking at the front of it?
Yeah. We need to go find a spot for our chairs.
Yes, we do.
Are you most excited for that one right there?
Yeah, in the bomber.
Woo, baby. Nice and crowded air show, huh?
This is nothing compared to some of the other ones.
I want to get a smoothie. You want a smoothie?
I'll share one with you.
Okay. Look, babe, it's the Warhawk.
Looks like some other one of the doing loops and stuff.
Aerobatics?
Yeah.
Wow. I want to see you do some aerobatics.
You do?
Go do some cartwheels on the runway, okay?
It's acrobatics.
Oh, that's what I meant.
S16.
Yeah.
Guys, I got some earplugs. Carson got a shirt. It's the F-16.
Look how the other shirt looks. This is a Cessna 172, it's the one I trained in.
This is the one you did your first solo in?
Not first solo, that's a 150.
This car has a jet engine on it, it's gonna race a plane, right?
It says it will, yeah.
That's what I'm talking about. Whoa. Oh my gosh. Babe. Whoa. Oh my God.
Time to run.
problem.
There's gonna be a light drizzle, so we'll go away soon.
Excited for the B1 Bomber?
Who are you?
I'm the F16.
Yeah?
Yeah. P51 Mustang!
Yeah, I've flown now.
What?
I've flown a P51 Mustang.
What?
Huh?
Are you lying?
No.
You've flown in it, guys.
18th birthday.
Brothers flying together in two planes doing aerobatics.
Has decided that he's going to retire finally. And now we're to land on top of the pickup truck. We're about 60 miles an hour and it has to keep it at 60 miles an hour. And in the confusion, Warren's going to just sort of get in his brother's face and come down in for it. Let's get to the truck. Here we go. Man, that's fancy. He's gonna actually loop and then try and do it. So let Nick get ahead. That's just crazy. Leading off the speed. And closer. Well, this is what he's doing. He's got lots of runway still ahead of him. Get out to the side. He gets the main gear down. He's gotta get the tail. Gotta scooch it forward. Wait.
A B-25 bomber?
Interesting to build it.
left the air show.
How was that for your first air show?
Oh my god, it was so much fun until the F-16 was flying over and I was trying to record it. And then my camera's battery died, so I had to whip out my phone. And then my sunscreen got in my eyes, so it was like water. And I was trying to film the F-16, and it was really cool though.
The F-16 was my favorite at the very end.
Yeah.
But I liked the old World War II planes, like the P-51 Mustang and P-40 Warhawk and Spitfire and all that. That was cool. And then the B-25 bomber was cool, flying around. There's some good aerobatic planes. I've seen a few of them before, but some new ones that I haven't seen before, which is cool.
Yeah.
So Carson got this cool shirt. You guys, look at the back.
There it is.
Wow, that is so cool. That's the F-16, right?
Uh-huh.
And then in the front, it's even cooler. I love it.
Got yellow and blue.
Yeah, that's a really cool shirt. So yeah.
I'm excited to wear it.
Don't forget to like and subscribe to this video and comment below what was your favorite part, and we'll see you guys in the next video.
Yeah guys, if you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe. It would mean the world to us.
Bye guys.
Miss us? We missed you, babe boy.